So what are you showing off here at Tokyo Game Show?
Well, we're showing at Tokyo Game Show a brand new mission in Venice, and in the mission, what we're really actually showing, and it's the way we divided a mission in different steps. So the first part of the mission is all about trying to approach your target, but before that, get rid of the guards surrounding his palace. So you go and eliminate five archers, and that leads you to another step, to another step, to another step. Eventually, you'll get to your target, Emilio, and you'll assassinate him inside his palace. This is what we're showing today. But doing so, we're also showing new moves, new elements of the game, like the fact that you can buy some dye to change the color of your clothes, like the fact that you can use some courtesans to distract the attention of guards, also the way you can climb faster with the fast climb, but also the climb leap, where you jump and you grab and you get to your heights faster. So that's what we're showing here at Tokyo Game Show.
And that is, you were taught that by a different group of characters.
Yes, in this mission in particular, you do your mission with the help of the thieves, of the Venetian thieves. And so Antonio, the thief leader, he's the one helping you out, telling you where to go next and what to do next. And that guy is also, helping you out before that mission, teaching you how to do the climb leap. So it's something new from AC1, is that the fact that you have friends now around you doing your mission.
And you will continuously learn more things to do throughout the game. And this is somewhere in the middle?
It's a little bit towards the end. Not towards the end, but it's not in the actual middle of the game. But yes, the game is divided into teaching, or we divided the game into skills that we teach the player. So this is still towards the end. You still have new moves, that new abilities that you will learn.
And could you set the stage, like what has happened in the story? Is that, or can you talk anything about that?
In here, you mean? Well, like I said, you arrived in Venice and you meet, eventually you'll meet Antonio. And Antonio will be your guide inside Venice. But that's, I don't want to go too much into details. I don't like to spoil the game for you. But the story is still the same as before, so you're still this, like, Ezio, the Italian noble, young at first, but then eventually getting a little bit older and becoming a master assassin. In this demo, it's pretty much, he's getting the master assassin feeling. He's not young anymore, let's say.
Could you tell us a little bit about the different ways you can escape this time? Because I feel that you've mixed it up a little bit more, and you're not you have more options on how to escape.
Well, yeah, it's something we worked on really hard to. We changed a little bit the escape loop. So there's different options. First, the first option is just like the first game: try to break the line of sight and then go inside a bale of hay or a well, or sit down on a bench, or sneak inside a group of people. But also the distance is also a factor. So if you outrun somebody like a guard, you'll be fine. But also with the introduction of water, you can now jump in water and hide by swimming underneath the water. So yes, I wanted something that's really precise for me, and I told the team I want a chase sequence or an escape loop that lasts only 30 seconds. I don't want it to be 2 minutes, So that's why there's much more opportunities now to hide than it was in the first game. So Venice is full of water, so it's full of place to hide. But it's higher also. So it's like we have spot on the rooftop, but in Venice, it takes more time to get to those. In other maps, it's easy to hide on the rooftop, see? So that's the balancing we did. Here there's more water, it's easier to jump in the water, but if you're on the rooftop and you go hide in the water, then eventually you have to get up there, see? In other city, you go up much easier, you hide in the rooftops, just like in the first game. So different vibration depending on where you are.
It's a price to pay.
Yeah, exactly. And that's how you balance a game. Sometimes you have to pay a bigger price.
Thank you very much for your time.